Welcome to Bonderite Goes Around the World. I'm your host, Chris Templeton. I'm really pleased to be here with Maziar Salarieh from the IMEA region. Thank you so much for being here, Maziar.
Thank you for having me. Thank you for inviting me.
It is my pleasure. Tell everybody a little bit about your background with Bonderite and what you do with them at this point.
Well, I've been working with the Henkel around 15 years, plus 15 years, in the variety of the industries, such as OEM, coil, coating, general industry, and for the adhesives, sealant, and the coating in the country and the regional role.
And what are you doing with them now?
So at the moment, I am responsible for the metal SBU in the country, which is the coil and coating and also general industry. And prior to that, I was responsible in the IMEA region for the functional coating business.
Tell everybody a little bit about the coil industry and the different applications that you help with at Bonderite.
So in the coil industry, in fact, the Henkel has the portfolio in the whole value chain, which is a start from the coil and it goes to the end user like appliance and tractor and general industry, in fact. So those area, so we are doing some, let's say, pre-treatment in the coil. Then after that, the coil will be transferred to the customer of the any industry, metal industry, then again it will be, let's say, cleaned and coated by Henkel portfolio, and it will be sent to the, let's say, the end user.
Maziar, talk a little bit about the metal pretreatment side of this business and the challenges that you face.
Yeah, so I think it is same for most of the industry. The challenge of the pretreatment is the coating industry. In fact, it is the, you know, we can categorize nowadays in the inflated raw material and also availability, which needs supply chain resilience, right? And having said that, entire value chain of the customer impacted by this, let's say, disruption. And one of our example, it would be, you know, the quality of the steel and the aluminum that we are getting, it is changed due to the unavailability. That's why this part of the job is the Henkel job is the more crucial to deliver the high quality of the, let's say, of the product to the end user. This would be, I think, the one challenge that we have seen recently. In the IMEA, in fact, we have also time lag of the some trend that you can see globally, like digitalization and also the some kind of the, let's say, industry trend that comes. However, for instance, as an example, the remanufacturing. So we do not have that much in this part of the world. But flip side of that, with the growing of the emerging market, so you can see the agriculture or rail industry in the India, for instance, is booming. Or there are lots of, you know, mass production in the Turkey, in the appliance. Or the coating also, it is the same that it is in the, let's say, in the all the region, specifically, let's say, in India and North Africa. Also, aluminium is the something that it is growing a lot. So those areas, I would say that, you know, it is something that maybe especially it is the growth level, I mean the CAGR level, it is more compared to the some advanced region.
So it sounds like there's two really big issues. One is just a lot of growth, and at the same time, because of supply chain backups, the quality of the metal is not as good as you would expect it to be. And so from that standpoint, is the importance of metal pretreatment that I can take something that's maybe not as high quality and create a surface that's still going to be well painted and that sort of, is that the approach?
You formulated very nicely.
Thank you. Okay, let's see. Talk a little bit more in detail about how you're solving these challenges in terms of meeting demand of working with metals that aren't quite as high quality. How does Bonderite solve those challenges?
So, I mean, now, you know, we have the, in this part of the world, in India and the Turkey specifically, we have the inspirational center, which basically it is the kind of the pilot test that we are doing some in-house testing to deliver the best and tailor-made solution to the customer. So that part is something that I think it is the when it comes to the that kind of the expertise, so Henkel is the has the very crucial and very interesting role on that. So this would be something that, you know, it is that we have as a part of the know-how business that we are delivering to the customer. Another thing also would be that, you know, since we have the global network, so we are doing a lot of benchmarking from the other part of the world, like in North America, like Europe, like APAC, those areas we are getting also some benchmarking, and we will leverage those, let's say, benchmark in our region. So those areas, I can tell you that, you know, Henkel, specifically in the metal pretreatment, they can support the customer to deliver the best result.
Talk a little bit about how you work with a customer, especially in today's market where you're really dealing with issues with the quality of the metal. It must be a very close relationship when you're helping them to determine what they need and how to do it in a way that's really going to work to their best advantage.
So in the COVID time, in fact, you know, we had the lots of virtual and the online, you know, troubleshooting and the solving the problem of the customer virtually, since it was the lockdown. So nowadays, after, you know, to some extent normalization, and we have the chance to see our customer, so we have seen lots of change happens in the customer value chain. Like, you know, as I said, you, for instance, lots of this kind of the shortage of the raw material or the other thing, or the quality of the steel that you are getting, it is not same as the previous. Why? Because you are now sourcing your coil from the different source, which normally our product should not fulfill the same specification. So we need to agile, check the quality of the steel and immediately change those area. So then we can secure the quality as in the past. Those area is the something, and I think it is the very valuable thing from the interaction from the our technical customer service with the customer head to head, you know, head to head discussion and the collaboration.
I imagine that customers are surprised at your level of engagement with them through this process of really understanding the changes of the metal and making sure that they're getting exactly what they're expecting as an end product for whatever the next stage is, coding, that sort of thing. Your clients must be really amazed at the level of participation you have.
Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, the you know, we always would like to set the benchmark in our industry by Henkel, right? So, and this would be something that as a one competitive advantage you can create to the help your customer, they can be champion also in their area for to competing in with their peer, right? So I think this is the one mission that, you know, overall we have to deliver such a this level of the best in class to the customer.
I imagine the customer loves that, but I can tell that it puts a smile on your face. It's a lovely thing to be able to deliver that level of quality and be backed by a company like Bonderite and Henkel, isn't it?
Yes, sure it is.
One of the things that really fascinates me about Bonderite is your commitment to sustainability. Talk about how that presents itself in your work and with your clients.
I am very happy you brought this in the table. So, yeah, that sustainability, in fact, it is a big part of our job, not only in the Bonderite, But in the overall Henkel, you know, we have the mission for 2030 that we need to reach that index of the carbon free. So as part of the Henkel also, as part of the Henkel in the Bonderite, we are also very committed to deliver those value to the customer. So like, for instance, as a one tangible answer to your question, it would be, you know, we are decreasing the heat of the stage of the customer, which at the end, you know, the electricity or the gas that they are using will decrease. So, and from the seven, now we are talking about the less, let's say two or maybe three stages, that it is the huge water consumption. So for you, and it is really impact of the, you know, now we have the scarcity of the water everywhere. So, and it is very valuable. So those area is the something that we have. From the other side, with our new technology, we do not use heavy metal, which is very dangerous and hazardous for the environment. So we are not using that, and we are using some kind of the element that is not that much that much dangerous for the, let's say, for the entire environment. So those area, I would say, that is the area that, you know, we are working very closely to the customer. And by the way, one thing that it is very interesting, in the past in IMEA, if you have talked about such a this, it was not that much welcome. But now it is something that, you know, when you are talking, the customer will say, hey, how much it is, why we are talking, how we can create the competitive advantage in our industry. So now I think everybody now is aware of the such a this sustainability, how important is this sustainability in the world.
You know, it strikes me that a lot of people probably initially heard sustainability and thought, oh, I don't really need that. But a big part of what sustainability is doing with the products that you're delivering is helping them to be more cost efficient, more power efficient, water efficient, efficient in terms of being better to the environment overall, no heavy metals. That must play a really big role in people's perception of, oh, wow, sustainability really is a great thing for mm-hmm. our business. And I imagine that you driving that really helps quite a bit.
Yeah, so, and you know, and I think this would be also highlighted that this sustainability also decrease you as a manufacturer, your total cost. So it is not only the thing that, you know, it is you are helping the society or the community. Also, your total cost will decrease because of all the things that I said to you, it translates to the money. So then total cost of you, it will decrease. Then it will reflect to the, you know, to your end user product. And, you know, then you can compete. Then you can compete as an end user. Let's say, imagine appliance, you can compete much better.
It really makes a big difference. And I'm impressed with your ability and Bonderite in general, because I've done a number of these podcasts where this focus on sustainability, but also taking it to a place of, hey, this is how this really serves you as a client in terms of being more competitive, having that competitive advantage. I really admire that in Bonderite.
Thank you.
You know, one of the things that you mentioned earlier was this delay in digitalization in the IMEA. And now what I understand is that because things are moving along much better in terms of digitalization, you're now able to provide some services and technology that helps your clients. Talk a little bit about that.
Yeah. So digitalization also something that, you know, also the customer is striving for that recently, right? And, you know, all this industry 4 and the automation is something that the customer is asking. So based on that, Henkel actually have the equipment with the brand of the Line Guard. So with this equipment, in fact, you can automate your line. Then your line also can distinguish all the, let's say, chemical parameter, and then it can automatically dosage in the, let's say, in the bath that it needs. Then also you have the digital, based on this, you automated the line. So from the other side also, you can see the, you know, with your smartphone, the all the data that, you know, you require to have. So I think this is the something that, you know, it is a very, very special in our, let's say, in our portfolio as a Henkel. So, but this is, we never stop this, right? Now we are moving to the next level, which is the online coating measurement. So then you have the real time data for your coating. Then you can understand how would be your corrosion resistant of your treatment, which is in the past you had to, even today you have to wait 1 month minimum or even more sometimes, that you understand today you do that some job, but you will get the result 30 days later. So if you have the real data, so then you can, you know, you can manage it immediately, and you can react it and, you know, adjust your all the line accordingly.
It must make a big difference in terms of two things. Number one, I'm getting more consistent quality, right? And then secondarily, it's helping me with supply chain down the line from there, where I don't have to wait 30 days to figure out where I am in terms of my corrosion and that sort of thing. Is that correct?
Yeah, so when we are talking about this consistency, so like you truly really mentioned, so if you have the graph, it will be, you know, sometimes your quality will be high, sometimes your quality will be low. Then you have this graph. But when you have the automated, then you have the one trend line, which is, because it is automated, is not that much, you know, up and down from the your quality. Then from the other side also, it manages your consumption. So because when you are high in the quality, maybe you do not need that much of the chemical. When you are low, maybe you need. So that's why also your consumption, it is high and down. Somewhere you don't need, somewhere you need. So that is something that it will put in the place the very necessary role. It is the something. And from the other side, about this, let's say 1 month that you have in the, you should check your corrosion after 1 month. Now you have the data and you can understand what would be the end user quality of the product. And this is the, basically this is the beauty of this, let's say, beauty of this online coating measurement.
When you look at the value that you bring to your customers, talk about it from their perspective. What are the things that you think your customers are most surprised by in terms of what Bonderite delivers to them?
Yeah, thank you for that question. So I've seen in my career a lot of time the happy face of the customer because of such a service that we delivered along with the, you know, our team. And, you know, those area is the area that, you know, the customer can also feel they will get the unique service and product from the Henkel as a partner. So I think this is the something that, you know, I think I am personally proud of that, because, you know, the feeling is good. The customer is satisfied. Then also you are basically, then you will be also satisfied for that. And I think this is the value creation of the Bonderite for the customer, which is unique.
Maziar Salarieh, you are the functional coating manager for the IMEA region. Thank you so much for being here. I really appreciate your time.
Thank you very much, Chris.